Hey, what's up? John Sanmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. So I got this question about this sort of dead zone between an absolute beginner and being a sufficient programmer. It says, hi, John. I'm a junior in high school, and I've recently decided that I would like to major in computer science in college. Once I decide on this major, I also decide to learn how to code. I have been making an effort to learn Java. I have taken a couple of free courses online and have watched about 3 hours worth of introductory lessons. I have a rudimentary idea of the language, but I cannot yet make a program on my own. I'm somewhere in between an absolute beginner and a sufficient programmer. My question for you is, what advice could you give me to help me progress into someone who can make a program and truly understand Java? Most lessons or book I have found are either far too advanced for me or totally for beginners and reiterate things I already know. I need something in the middle. Thank you. So this is sort of the dead man's land where a lot of developers end up and stay for a long time. I stayed in this area for a long time. This is normal. This is the phase that really you determine whether or not you have what it takes to make it, and you just have to sort of push through this. So I'm going to give you some tips to help you push through it. So there's a couple things you can do. One of them is to realize that you're just going to keep on doing and doing and doing until it clicks. This is sort of the point where you're developing sort of a mastery. And right now things feel forced and difficult. When you're first learning to drive and you first get your driver's license, right? It was like you're paying attention to the mirror and like, are you braking too hard? Are you hitting the gas too hard? Are you, oh, I can't stay in the lane because, right? And it's frustrating. You're trying to do all these things and backing up. Oh, I got to look in my rearview mirror and you know, what's going on? You're frazzled, right? And it's all this conscious process. But eventually, what ends up happening is now you drive and you're like, you're eating a Big Mac and you're smoking a cigarette at the same time and you're texting, you know, you're doing all this stuff at the same time, right? And it's just so easy. And that's what's gonna happen to some degree. I mean, you probably won't be able to eat a Big Mac and smoke a cigarette and code at the same time. But maybe with voice dictation, I don't know, maybe you could do it. So the thing is, though, it's gonna happen. It's gonna click like that. And it clicked for me, it clicks for those of you that are listening. Give a thumbs up and put a comment below if it clicked for you. If you're in this dead man zone and you were a beginner and then you clicked and you became advanced, right? It's gonna happen. The way that it's gonna happen is by repetition, by doing a lot. Start writing code, create programs, do as much as you can, and then force yourself to expand beyond your comfort zone. So figure out what the edge is, and then you want to move outside the edge a little bit. So for you, if you can't write a program, a full program, figure out some simple program that you're going to create. I always say to copy someone else's, so copy some program that exists out there, and force yourself to go through the painful process of just going through it. It's going to be hard. You don't know how to do it now, but just figure it out every step of the way. Figure out, okay, I'm stuck here. I'm going to go beyond. And once you go through that process, it's going to be painful and hard. Then you're going to do it again. It's going to be a little bit easier. And then you're going to be like, oh man, I created 5 apps and I can, if you tell me a program to create, I could just do it. I know how to do it, right? But you're going to have to force yourself to go through that learning process. The other thing I would say is, you know, at one point when I was younger, I wanted to know about science. So I got a subscription to Discover magazine and I didn't understand crap in those articles. I like every other word was a mystery to me, but I forced myself to read them. And I became really good at biology and science just by forcing. Pretty soon I started understanding them. I did the same thing with MSDN magazine. When I first started as a software developer, I had no clue what half of the stuff in MSDN magazine was, but I forced myself to read every article and then I started to understand. Pretty soon it was like, oh, whoa, I actually understood this. I got this concept and that helped it click for me. So anyway, that's all you gotta do. Just keep pushing through. If you like this video, subscribe to the channel and I'll talk to you next time. Take care.